إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين صدق الله العظيم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My dear respected brothers, respected elders, respected ulama-e-kiram, respected friends and youngsters, respected mothers and sisters who may be listening at home, I greet you all with a greeting of al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I testify that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his last and final messenger. Let's start today's talk, let's start today's bayan of even imagination. Let's picture, let's imagine that you wake up in the middle of the night, you open your eyes and you are paralyzed in shock, you are paralyzed in terror with what you are confronted with. You are engulfed in a blazing fire. You are engulfed in a blazing fire. This fire, you see nothing else but this fire. You look to your left, you look to your right, you look in front of you, you see nothing but this fire. Thick smoke is covering the air. You have no hope of survival. You look to your nearest escape. You look towards the windows, but there is no escape. You now have no hope of survival. You have no hope of survival or escape. What do you do? At this time, all of a sudden, the door flings open. A figure is stood there. This figure rushes to your aid. This figure comes towards you. He lifts you up. He rushes you out the door before the roof can cave in. You look towards the face of your Savior. Who can this person be? Who can this person be who is willing to risk his own life to save your life? He's willing to sacrifice his own life for your well-being. Who can this be? You look towards his face. The most beautiful face you have ever laid your eyes upon. More beautiful than the moon on the 14th night. Who can this person be? Is this nothing but a dream? Is this nothing but a nightmare? No, my brothers, this is reality. This is none other than A'zam al-Khalq, Ashraf al-Khalq, Anwar al-Khalq, Ajmar al-Khalq, Akram al-Khalq, Khatam al-Nabiyyin, Rahmatul lil-Alameen, Habibullah, Nabiullah, Rasulullah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is your savior. In this zamane jahiliya, in the time of ignorance, in the days of ignorance, the state of the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum was such, the conditions of the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum was such that they had no shame. They had no shame in bowing down in front of those very idols which they would create with their very own hands. They had no shame in committing the sin of adultery, zina. They had no shame in burying their very daughters alive, the innocent masoom daughters alive, 6 feet in their grave. This was the condition of the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. They were destined to be doomed. In store of for them was the fire of Jahannam, regarding which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the glorious Quran, وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. the fuel of which will be insan, mankind, humans, and stone. They were doomed until rahmatul lil alamin, the mercy of all mankind, came to their savior, came as their savior. He saved them from this fire of Jahannam. He sacrificed himself. He transformed the worst of mankind to walk on the surface and earth, the surface and the face of this earth, the worst of mankind into the greatest of mankind to walk on the face and surface of this earth. They were the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. They became the greatest companions, the like of Hazrat Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Hazrat Usman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Hazrat Ali ibn Abi Talib karramallahu wajhahu radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Hazrat Khalid bin Walid, Hazrat Mu'adh bin Jabal, Hazrat Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, Hazrat Talha bin Ubaidullah, Hazrat Zubair bin Awam radiallahu ta'ala anhum. They became the kibari sahaba. They became the greatest of companions. They were transformed from the worst of people to become the best of people. They were forever in debt to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He saved them from the fire of Jahannam, so they were now in debt to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they had the utmost respect and love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. On one occasion, when the companion Hazrat Khubayb bin Adi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he was captured by the mushrikeen. He was captured by the polytheists. They dragged him till the outskirts of Makkah. They wanted to kill him slowly. They wanted to cut him bit by bit, little by little. They wanted to rip apart his flesh. They began to pierce him with their swords and their spears. And whilst he was in this excruciating pain, this unbearable torture, this great amount of torture and torment, on this occasion, Abu Sufyan, who was not yet a Muslim, he approaches Khubayb. He approaches Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he says, "Oh Khubayb, do you not wish today that you be in the comfort of your home, and that Muhammad be here in your place? Do you not wish that you be in the comfort of your home, and Muhammad be in your place today?" Just listen to the answer of Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar. Whilst in this pain, he replies back to Abu Sufyan. He says, "You are asking me about this excruciating pain. I swear by Allah, death is more easier for me than that a little thorn prick Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Death is more asan, death is more sahal, death is more simple for me than a little thorn prick Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam." This was the condition of their heart. This is the love that they possessed for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. These were the Sahaba kiram radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And then Khubayb bin Adi, he turns towards the mushrikeen. He says to the mushrikeen, "Grant me permission that I may pray two rakat salah." They granted him permission. He prayed two rakat salah in front of his Lord, in front of his Khalik, in front of his Malik. After finishing, he turns towards the mushrikeen, towards the polytheists, and he says that, "I have prayed mukhtasar rakat, I have prayed short rakat, only because I do not want you thinking that I fear my death." And then he supplicates to Allah. He lifts his hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says to Allah, "Oh Allah, we have believed in you. We believed in your messenger. We believed in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We followed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now convey my message to your beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now convey my salam to your beloved." And narrations mention that on this occasion, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Madinatul Munawwara. He was sat in Madinatul Munawwara, and sitting with him was Hazrat Usama bin Zayd radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And he says that, "I saw the blessed tears of my Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam begin to flow from his eyes. I saw the blessed tears of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he begins to cry profusely. He cannot control himself. He says that Khubayb has just sent his salam. He says Khubayb has just sent his salam. And it was upon this occasion, my brothers, that Abu Sufyan, he makes a statement. He says that I have sat with the emperors of Persia and I have sat with the emperors of Rome. I swear by Allah, the followers of the emperors of Persia and the followers of the emperor of Rome do not possess the love that the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam possess for him. Look at this statement. This was the love that the Sahaba kiram radiyallahu ta'ala anhum possessed for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He saved them from the torment of Jahannam. He saved them from that blazing hellfire, and they are forever in debt to him. The state of the Sahaba was such that they could not even bear to see. They could not bear to see anyone say anything against Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They could not bear to see anyone inflict any amount of pain upon Khatam al-Nabiyyin, Rahmatul lil-Alameen, Habibullah, Nabiyullah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They would act as the human shields in the ghazawat, in the war, in the battles. The likes of Talha bin Ubaidullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the likes of Sa'd bin Abi Waqas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, in the battlefield, they will stand in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They will stand there so no arrow can reach their beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They will put their own body on the line. They will sacrifice their own lives for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They could not even bear to hear anyone utter a word against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The likes of Hazrat Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the likes of Hazrat Khalid bin Walid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, were ready to cut the necks off. They were ready to cut the heads of those people who would even utter a word against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This was the love that the Sahaba, that they possessed for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this Nabiullah, this Khatam al-Nabiyyin, is that very Prophet. He was not only sent to the Sahaba kiram, he was not only sent to the Prophet, to the people of that time. He is Rahmatul lil Alameen. He is the mercy for all of mankind. He was sent for every single person. He was sent for every single person sitting in this masjid today. He sacrificed his own life. He shed blood. He shed tears for this ummah. And on this note, I will leave. There's a hadith. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين. That no one can be a perfect believer. No one from amongst you can be a perfect believer until I, as in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, become more beloved to him than his parents, than his children, and then the whole of mankind. And the Sahaba kiram, they did justice to this hadith. They implemented this hadith to the full. I leave on this note. I leave you to ponder upon this question. Have we fulfilled his right? Have we fulfilled his haq? Have we fulfilled this obligation? May Allah give us all the tawfiq to act upon what has been said. May Allah give us the ability to possess that same love that the Sahaba kiram radiyallahu ta'ala anhum possessed for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May Allah grant us the intercession of our beloved Nabiullah, Rasulullah, Habibullah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the day of judgment, on the day of reckoning. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.